Hey, hello everyone. Welcome to Mithun Technologies. So in this video, I'm going to show you how to install that JBazaar Wildfly Enterprise Application Server. So here we are calling JBaaS or Wildfly. So initially we were calling that JBaaS from 1.x version to 7.x version. We were calling that JBaaS. So from 8.x version to till the latest version, 25.x version, I think. So they have renamed from JBaaS to the Wildfly. So JBaaS or Wildfly, both are same. So they have renamed from, they have changed the name. I think in 2014, November month, they have changed the name from JBaaS to the Wildfly. So JBaaS or Wildfly is an enterprise application server. It can be used to deploy the web applications as well as enterprise applications. Means we can deploy WAR files and we can deploy ER files also. But whereas Tomcat server, in the Tomcat server, we can deploy only the WAR files. Right? We are not able to deploy the ER files. We are not able to deploy the enterprise applications. So if you have any requirement, if you want to deploy a enterprise application, and if you are looking that open source, you can go with the Wildfly server. Tomcat and Wildfly, both are open source. You don't want to pay the money. But Tomcat is not supporting that running the enterprise applications. So we are going to discuss now about how to install this Wildfly server, then how to deploy that WAR file, ER file, we'll see in this video. So if you want to install this Wildfly server, so what are the prerequisites we need? So 1 GB RAM server is enough, but in this example, in this video, what I'm going to do, I will install this Wildfly server, then I'm going to deploy that some applications. So to run those applications very quickly, so better to go with a 4 GB RAM server. Just for installing Wildfly server, 1 GB is enough. And you have to install the Java. Java is the prerequisite software for installing that Wildfly server. Right. So first, let me go to that AWS admin console. There I can create one EC2 instance which is having that 4 GB RAM. So what I'm going to do while creating this server, so first let me select that Red Hat. Then here I'm going to select that T2 medium. So go here, next, preview and launch, right, launch. So here I'm going to select that. So already existing key pair is there. So this is the key pair and click on launch. So like this, first you can create a one EC2 instance, then give the name for this one. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to give just mouse over here and you will see that edit icon. Click on here. So give that Wildfly server. Wildfly server. Wildfly server. So now you can connect to this server and you can install that Java first. So if you want to install the Java in the Linux server, if you go to my Mithun Technologies blog, see here. Okay, so the URL will be like Mithun Technologies -devops.blogspot.com. Right, just scroll down. You will see here Java is the one label. Right, so here I have created one post how to install this Red Hat Java in the Red Hat Enterprise Linux server. So just follow these steps. So first let me connect to the server, whatever the server which I have created. So select that server, click on connect. So take this command, open the Git bash or mobile extern. So whatever the SSH tool which you are like, then connect to that server. So first go to the folder where your PEM files are there. So here my PEM files are there. Then connect to that server. So say yes. We have successfully connected. Just execute uname command and verify it whether you have connected to the Linux server or not successfully. So we have connected to the Linux server. Just execute sudo space su space -hyphen to switch to the root user. See here, just follow these things. So then go to the OPT directory. So copy paste all these commands. Control C, go here and Control V. So it is going to execute one by one command later. So first it will go to the OPT directory, then it will install the wget command. Why we need to install the wget command? The package to download that Java software, we are going to use a wget command, right? So that's why first see here, you need to install this package, wget package. Then we are going to download this Java RPM file, right? Then we are going to install. So after that, we are executing Java hyphen version command to verify it whether Java is installed or not. Right. So see here, Java has successfully installed. So now we have to install that JBoss. So for that one also, I have created one blog. So if you go and see here, JBoss on Wildfly, click on this one. So if you see here, login as a root user, already we have logged in, and go to the OPT directory and download that whatever the version of Wildfly software you want to install. So for that one, so if you go and see here, this is my URL where I have created all the DevOps related softwares downloaded page. So here you see I have created one entry for this one, downloading this Wildfly server. Click on this one, it will take you to that the official download page for downloading the Wildfly. So the latest version is 25.x version. So if you want to download this zip file, so or you can download the tar file also. Okay, so right click on this zip file, copy link location. Okay, so wget and this one, right? So now take this command. Okay, so right now we are in the OPT directory and download this one. So once if you execute this command, it is going to download this zip file. So after downloading, we have to extract it, right? So if you see, it has downloaded. Now you can try ls command. See, this Wildfly software has downloaded. Just execute that unzip command and you can extract it. So it is saying that unzip command not found. What you have to do? You have to install it. YVM unzip, YVM install. Unzip iPhone Y. Okay, so it is installed, the unzip package. Now you can execute unzip command, unzip Wildfly. See, it is extracting. It is extracted successfully now. Just type ls. This is a directory. Now if we go inside this Wildfly directory and if we see bin directory, dogs, domain, standalone, right? Now we'll go back one level up. So now you are in OPT directory. There you will see this one. So this is your Wildfly home directory. Wildfly home directory means where you have extracted. There you will see some directories, some files are there, right? So after downloading and extracting, what you have to do? You have to go to this particular standalone directory. There you will see that configuration one directory. Inside the configuration directory, so we have one file called as a standalone.xml file. So go to that standalone one directory, go inside that standalone. So there you will see that configuration. So go inside that configuration. We see here one file called as standalone.xml file. So just open that standalone.xml file and update the local IP address is there. So just search with 127.0.0. Okay. So just what you will do, you can search with 127.0.0.0. Okay. So take this one. If you want to search, you have to type that forward slash. There you can keep it and hit the enter. So it is saying that it is not found. Or just scroll down. Or you can search with this one. So WSDL tag. Okay. So what you will do? So go here, forward slash this one. So here see that 127.0.01. So not the 00. 127.0.01. If you search, it will come here. So what you will do? Take that, remove this one, this IP address. Okay. And keep that your server public IP address or private IP address. So better to keep that private IP address, because your server, if you restart, private IP address is not going to change. Okay. So copy this one, private IP address, and paste it here. So like that, two more places that local IP address is there. So here see, just replace that local IP address with the your server, Linux server, private IP address or public IP address where you are installing this Wildfly server. Okay. So save it. Then you have to create a user. So if you want to create a user, so go back to the bin directory. CD. So right now, if you see, you are in Wildfly home directory. There you will see that bin directory. So go inside that bin directory. So there you will see that add user.sh file. Add user.sh file. Using this shell script, we can create the user. So if you want to create a user, we can execute this command sh add user.sh. Okay, so here two types of users are there, management user, application user. So you have to create that management user for deploying the application. So I am going to give the username. So Mithun Technologies. So password. So whatever the password you want, you can give. So I am going to give that some password. And re-enter the password. So which groups you want to belong? So I'm not giving any group names, just hit the enter. Okay, so about to add user to that relay management relay. Yes, you can say yes and hit the enter. So say yes. So now you have successfully created one user. Right. So now you want to start that server. So just we have created user. You want to start the server. So if you want to start the server, If you see here, we have one file called as standalone.sh. Standalone.sh. Just run sh standalone.sh. Okay. So once if you execute that shell script, so it is going to run your server. If you see here, started 298 of 538 services. Okay. So total it took 4,077 milliseconds to start the server. Now your WildFly server is up and running. So if you want to access this WildFly server from our laptop, what you have to do? So take that server public IP address where you have installed that WildFly server and http://, the default port number for your WildFly server or JBoss server is 8080, even for Tomcat also 8080. So now take this one and go to browser and try to access it. You are not able to access it. Why? Because you didn't enable that port number 8080. So go to your, so first select that server, click on security. So here you will see that security groups. Click on the security groups, right? Then click on edit inbound rules. So add rule. So here under type, so you can select that custom TCP or all TCP. If you select custom TCP, you have to enable that whatever the port number you want. So if you want to enable all the ports, select that all TCP. So under source, you can select anywhere IPv4 address, means from anywhere you can access this server and you can save the rule. Okay, so now you can go here, just refresh it. Okay, so you can able to access it. See, this is a WildFly welcome homepage. So if you want to log in into administration console, see here, click on this administration console. So then it is going to ask that credentials, right? So already we have created a credentials, right? So we have created the credentials. The username is Mithun Technologies, right? So password, I have given some password. So here, so it is taking time. So click on refresh. So it is going to take some time. See, then it will come. It is going to ask the username. So give the username is Mithun Technologies. And password, whatever the password you have given while creating, give that password. Click on sign in. So here, see, this is a admin console. So using this management console or admin console, we can deploy the application into that WildFly server. So if you want to deploy the application, see here, deployments, one tab is there. Click on this one. See here, right now, no applications are deployed. So here you will see that drop down. There you will see that upload deployment, right? So R, click on this plus symbol. It is going to take you to that deployment, or click on this one. See here, choose file or drag it here. Click on this one and it will ask which file you want to deploy. So if you see here, I have a WAR file. So first let me deploy this WAR file. So I have selected that maven-web-application.war and click on deploy. Okay, so here if you click on finish it. Now your application is deploying. So once if you deploy this application, you can see this application. Okay, so application is deployed successfully. So you can click on close and see here your application is running. This is the context path. So now this is your application. This is your server URL. So in this server, you have deployed one application. So what is the context path? So this is a context path by default. So whatever the var file name is there, that is the var file name. That is the context path. So with this URL, you can able to access the application. Okay. So take this URL, go to your browser, open new tab. You have already opened that browser. And see here, you can able to access it. Right. So if you want to stop this application, so go here. If you see here, disable. So now your application is disabled, means stopped. Now you can go here, and if you try to access it, you are not able to. You are getting that 404, not found. This is one of the HTTP status code, right? 404 means not found, page not found. Right. So now you can go here and you can click on enable. Click on enable. So now if you go and see here, it is going to work. Right. See. So like this, you can deploy the application, you can stop the application. And suppose if you want to undeploy, if you want to remove, okay, see here, undeploy. So replace means if you want to deploy that updated var file, see, you have developed one application and you have created a package. After that, again, you have added some more features. Now, you have created another var file. So that is having that some extra features. If you want to deploy that updates, you can use the replace. Okay. So undeploy. If you click on this undeploy, it is going to remove this application from the server. Right. So now if you try to access this one, it is not going to work. Right. So now what I'm going to do, I am going to deploy that ER file. So already ER file is there in my laptop. Okay. So click on upload deployment. So here, so you can select that var file. So already I have created one enterprise application. So this project is there in my GitHub organization. I have downloaded and I have created a package. So if you go and see that ER module in the target directory, you will see that one ER. Select that one. So we have selected ER. See, click on next. Okay. See here, enabled. So if you make it enabled, it will deploy and it will be available. If you make it disabled, your application is going to deploy, but you are not able to access it. Later you can enable it. So I'm enabling now itself. So then see here, if you want, you can rename that runtime name also. So click on finish. So now it is deploying that ER file. So we have deployed var file and we have deployed successfully that ER file also. Now, if you want to access this application, see here, the context path. So here it is going to give guys, see, context rules. Okay. So take this one. So now take this your application server URL with the, see, just observe that this is different context path. This is different context path. Each application have unique context path. So now you can go here, just access it. Right? See, this is having different GUI. Right? So for that, where I was using that, adding some IP addresses under. Right? So like this, you can deploy var file and ER file in the JBoss or Wildfly enterprise application server. Now you guys clear about, right, the difference between Tomcat and JBoss or Wildfly server. In the Tomcat, you can deploy only the var files, web applications you can deploy, but in JBoss or Wildfly, you can deploy enterprise applications also along with web applications. So guys, if you have any questions, you can reach out to Mithun Technologies and you can subscribe my Facebook for any free webinars which we are going to publish in our Facebook. And also, if you see, we have one very good YouTube channel is there. So go to your browser, open that YouTube, search with Mithun Space Technology Space DevOps, and you are going to see that Mithun Technologies YouTube channel. There, if you click on videos, you will see that many videos are there. Just go through these videos. It's very useful for DevOps professionals. Okay. So if you have any questions, you can reach out to Mithun Technologies contact number, or you can send an email to this one. So don't forget to subscribe my YouTube channel. After that, don't forget to click on this bell icon. So if you click on this bell icon, as soon as we post that new video, it is going to send a notification. Okay. Thank you.